very important. First one is very easy, second one is somewhat difficult. Okay, so we will be discussing the diode capacitances, right? So first one, under forward bias condition. Okay, name I will tell you based on the operation, right? So leave place for the name of the capacitance, right? So what happens first? Let us see what happens under forward bias condition in a PN junction diode. Okay, this is P, this is N. Resistance to protect the diode, and then right, this is say forward voltage. Fine. What happens is, what are the majority charge carriers on this side? Poles. What are the majority charge? Okay, some electrons are also there. What are the majority charge carriers on X side? The electrons. Okay. Okay, some holes are also there, but the majority charge carriers are the electrons. Okay. Now, what happens? What exactly happens under forward bias condition is, holes are what charged?
Positive
charged. So the positive charge will be repelled by this positive charge. They will move into N region. Okay? Right? Now, let us take one real life example. You have seen somebody smoking. Okay? This is something similar to that. This is something similar to that. It is like holes injected into N region. Right? So it is like a person smoking. He is leaving out the smoke. Okay? Now, what happens? Say, person has taken, he is taking only one puff. Right? Listen. So he has left the smoke. After 5 minutes, can you see the smoke? What is happening? It is diffusing. Okay? Right? What is diffusion, anybody? See, when a person is smoking, he is releasing the smoke. At that time, high concentration. Now this one, it is diffusing. Okay? So this is traveling from high concentration to low concentration. It is spreading in the entire atmosphere. That is the reason. Okay? It is spreading so much that you are not able to see. Right? Similar action takes place here. Holes are injected. Okay? It is like taking a smoke. Holes injected into N region. Now, suddenly you have holes here. These holes will diffuse. Okay? Right? So the important operation that takes place under forward bias condition is diffusion. Right? Hence the name of the capacitor under forward bias condition, it is called as diffusion. What is the name of the capacitance under forward bias condition? Diffusion capacitance. Because diffusion takes place. Holes, they come into N region, now they will spread, they will diffuse. Likewise, electrons will go into P region, they diffuse. Right? Fine. So, the name we have understood. Now we will go for the mathematical analysis. For that, we need diode current equation. What is diode current equation? What is diode current equation? I is equal to I naught into e power V by eta V D minus one, very important. This one already we have seen in the previous class. Previous classes we have seen this. Okay. Now, if we multiply this I naught inside, this is I naught into e power v by beta vt minus I naught. Usually I naught is a what quantity? Small quantity or large quantity? I naught is a small quantity. Usually leakage current. Okay? Or reverse saturation current. Leakage current. So usually I naught is small. So usually I is much greater than I naught. Okay? Since I is much greater than I naught, what you can get here? This I naught we can neglect and we can say I is nearly equal to I naught e power, right? What is the relation between current and charge? What is current? Current is nothing but rate of flow of charge, right? Current is nothing but rate of flow of charge. Fine? So, charge by time will give current. Clear? Charge by time will give current. Okay? Now, so what will Q be from this? Q will be I into tau. Call this 1, call this 2. So what is Q? Substitute. Yes? Substitute equation 1 in equation 2. Okay? Equation 1 we are substituting in equation 2. Q will be what? I naught e power v by theta vt into tau. I will think like this. Tau I naught e power v by theta. Right? Now, what is relation between capacitance and charge? What is the relation between capacitance and charge? See, capacitance. Okay? For a capacitor, capacitance is, if you give voltage, the charge it can hold. Right? Charge per voltage is the capacitance. So, right? Exact relation is dq by d. Right? Capacitance is charge per voltage. So, we have to differentiate this with respect to V. Right? So, differentiating Q with respect to V, what do we get? Okay, so we can write it like this. Dv of tau I naught e power V by theta Vt. What we can pull out here? Tau I naught we can pull out. Because they are constants. They don't have V tau. So, tau I naught. Differentiation of e power v by eta vt, what will that be? Yes? What will this be? Differentiation of d by dv of e power. What is that? Anybody? E power ax. A into e power ax. Differentiation of e power ax is A into e power ax. Okay? So here in place of x we have v. Right? So this will be tau I naught. Tell anybody, tell me what will this be? Tau I naught?
1 by.
1 by? In place of A we have 1 by eta v. Right? Into e power? Okay, V by theta. Right? Call this equation number Okay, further let me rearrange like this. So CD will be, can I write like this? Tau by eta VT into I naught e power V by, can I write like this? The I naught, okay, right? The eta VT I am leaving front. I naught I am taking, I am just rearranging this. Okay? So what is this from equation 1? What is this from equation 1?
I.
Okay? Right? So this I will call 3. This one I will call 3. From equation 1, equation 3 can be written as CD is equal to tau I by, this is the expression for the diffusion capacitance or the capacitance under forward bias current. Clear? Right? Any doubt? Very simple. We are taking diode current equation, neglecting I naught. Okay? Then we are taking current as charge, okay, rate of law of charge is correct. So Q by time we are taking this one, then this tau we are multiplying on the other side, so Q is equal to tau into I. Okay, the I from the diode current equation we are substituting after neglecting I naught. Then we are differentiating this with respect to V over. Okay? Differentiating with respect to V, then we have identified that, you know, e power something, if you differentiate, again you get e power. Similar term. That is the reason again we are getting I. We are getting back the I. This is the expression for the diffusion capacitance. Okay? What is the new term here? Diode current. Okay, one for silicon, two for germanium. This one, okay, volt equivalent of temperature, Vt. All this we have seen. What is new here? Tau. Okay, the tau is called as average lifetime of charge. Yeah. Average lifetime of charge carriers. Now listen, the same smoke example that I told. Okay? Charge carriers, say, holes are injected from P region to N region. Right? But now what happens? The holes, when they travel in the N region, they recombine with the free electrons. Okay? Right? Then when they recombine, they are lost. Lost means they are dead. Right? So, for some time they will live and then they die. Okay? The average time, the average lifetime they live before recombining. That is tau. Clear? Any doubts? We'll go for the next one. Next one is somewhat difficult. Okay? I will explain logically clearly. Please concentrate. Okay? You have to raise your concentration to understand this easily. Anybody writing this? Raise your hand. Okay. Okay, now which bias condition we have to consider? Reverse, forward already over. Okay, diffusion capacitance. Next, under. Likewise, after explaining, I will tell you the title. What is the name of the capacitance? After explaining, I will tell. Now let us consider under. rivers, fires, okay, under rivers, fires condition. What region will come across in a PN junction diode when it is rivers bias? Yes. What region at the junction? Depletion region. Okay. Anyway, so let us quickly recollect what happens under rivers bias condition. Okay. Right. Few logical questions I will ask you. If you are able to answer that, think and answer. Okay, you will be able to understand this entire derivation very easily. So okay, so P side, N side, what are the majority size carriers? Holes here, free electrons. Okay. So anyway, let me draw. Say another four holes. Let me draw. Right. When an atom loses electron, it becomes what ion? Positive ion. Right. Okay. So I have only represented the free electron. If I represent the complete atom, it will be free electron plus positive ion. Right. Okay. What positive ion? This together is the dopant impurity atom. This together is the positive ion plus the free electron together is one dopant impurity atom. Okay, fine. So anyway, let me completely represent this. So each free electron associated with a positive ion, right? Likewise, hole associated with negative ion. Very good. Hole, each hole associated with negative ion. Now let us consider reverse bias case. Okay. Reverse bias means what material you have to connect here? Negative. This side positive. Okay. Let me call it as some V bar. Reverse voltage. Now what happens? Electrons are what charge? Electron charge negative. So they will be attracted by this positive charge here. So they will move. Right? So say this one has moved. Okay? Likewise, this one has moved. The charge carriers have moved. Then hole is what charge? Positive charge. So while the hole will move towards this side, so this one shifted, right? So this one gone. Then likewise this one shifted. Okay. Now if you see in this region from here to here, there are no charge carriers, right? This region is called as depletion region. Why? Because it is depleted of charge carriers. Understand the English meaning of the word depleted. It doesn't have charge carriers. Okay? Because this region is depleted of charge carriers, it is called as depletion region. Okay? The other name for depletion region is transition region. Okay, the other name for depletion region is transition region. Okay, hence the name of this capacitance is transition region. Now see this structure. What is the structure of a parallel plate capacitor? Two plates in between insulator. Insulator means no charge carriers, right? So here also no charge carriers, isn't it? Depletion region, depleted of charge carriers, no charge carriers. So So the depletion region is equivalent to insulator. Okay, and the boundaries of the depletion region will act as the parallel plates. Okay, hence it gives capacitive effect. Okay, hence it gives capacitive effect. First case from dQ by dt we have taken the capacitive effect. Here from the structure itself we can identify the capacitive effect. Okay, now we have taken uniform equal doping, isn't it? 4 impurities on P side, 4 impurities on N side. We have taken equal. Now let us take, okay, heavily doped case. Right? Let us take heavily doped case. Again, questions for all of you. Okay? Anybody writing this, raise your hand. Okay, next we are taking heavily doped. Okay, heavily doped case. What is the situation? Okay, let us say they are here. Negative ions on T side, then positive ions on right. Now again let us say we have considered the reverse bias case, right? Okay, likewise, let us assume that here we have holes, okay. Let us say the charges here are lost. Likewise, the charges here are lost. Then, second column, third column, we have charges. So, the depletion region is only this much. Now tell me, when we increase doping, the width of the depletion region, is it increasing or decreasing?
Decreasing.
Okay? Right? So important point. Very, very important point to consider any semiconductor device. Okay? Important bullet point for any semiconductor device is if you increase the doping, then depletion region, what happens? Decreases. Right? It could be diode, it could be bipolar junction transistor, any semiconductor device. When you increase doping, the width of the depletion region will reduce. Right? Now, think and give me answer. See here, both sides slightly doped. Both sides heavily doped. One side if you dope lightly, the other side if you dope heavily, what will be the situation? Where we dope heavily, there the width of the depletion region will be less. Okay? Where we dope lightly, the width of depletion region will be more. Let us take that situation next. P side, let us take lightly low. Okay? Right? N side heavily doped. standard representation heavily doped is represented by N plus. Okay, any semiconductor device, if you find N plus, what it means? Heavily doped with N type impurities. Clear? Okay. Now what will be the situation? Let us consider. Okay. So let me draw like this. I will draw say four here. 1, 2, 3, 4. This side, this side. This side I will draw say 6. Okay. Here false. Then here 3 electrons. Now under reverse bias condition, okay, right, charges at the junction are lost, they are moved apart. Okay, the charges at the junction, they are moved apart, right. Let us say this charge is moved, this charge is moved, this one lost. Then here, till here no charge carriers. Then till here no charge carriers. Okay. The charge lost. Hello. Comments here. Passed. Second place. So this one. Okay. This one we will call it as XP. Okay? The depletion region on the P side. This one, what should we call it as? XN. The total depletion from here to here, we will call it as W. Total depletion rate. So what will W be here? Anybody? Easy question. W will be XP plus XN. Okay? Right? Anybody writing this? Raise your hand. Okay. Now, okay, this W I am writing here. W is equal to XP plus XN. Right? Let us see the charge distribution here. Okay? Charge distribution. What about the charge on inside? The value is high. Okay? On inside, the value is high because they will drop more charge. On the P side, this is charge density. Okay? On this, okay? On this side, charge density is less, likely to. So let me take small value. Okay? Right? Negative ions you have until the end of the this entire region. Okay? So I will represent like this. Fine? Next. What is the charge distribution on N region? Okay. Same dotted line. This point. Okay. From here to here. Right. This point is Q multiplied by What do you call the gopher? Which one you call it as donors? Which one you call it as acceptors? P side? P side? P side. Okay. See, N side, listen. N side, it is donating one extra free electron. Right? N side, it is donating extra free electron. So, N side, it is donor. Okay? N side, donor. P side, acceptor. The impurities on P side we call it as acceptor, the impurities on N side we call it as donor. Right? Now, so this value will be given by, okay, Q equal, where Md is concentration of donor impurity on N side. Okay? Right? Simple. More the doping, right? More the charge density. Isn't it? More the doping, okay? More will be the charge density. Q is nothing but the charge of electron. Right? Q is nothing but charge of electron. Okay? Right? So what will this point be, anybody? What will this point be? This side Ng, so this one will be in terms of Na. So Na Q, because it is along the negative axis, minus 1. Right? Now, these two areas will be equal. Okay? These two, because what is happening? The charges that are, the holes that are lost here, and then, okay, the electrons that are lost here, because of that, what happens is this area will be equal to this area. So, what is area? Q Nd multiplied to the what as you multiply? Anyway, this one into what is this point? From here to here it is xn. Okay? From here to here it is xp. Area will be this one into this one. So Q and A into XL is equal to first Q NA into X. Okay? Now, whenever you have charges, okay, right? These are immobile charges exposed. Whenever you have charges, there will be electric field associated with it. Right? Okay? Now, if we travel along this distance, if we travel along this distance, then this is neutral. Neutral. So, electric field is zero. Now, if we move along this path, gradually the electric field will increase. Maximum here. Then again it will decrease. Then zero. Right? Tell me whether the electric field in this case is positive or negative. What bias we are considering here? Reverse bias. So, the electric field will be negative because we are giving negative voltage. Okay? Right? So, if you draw the electric field, okay, it will be like this. See here, y-axis along the junction. Okay, same y-axis electric field along the junction. Right? I am actually supposed to draw here. I don't have place. You will draw exactly under this. Okay? Clear? Then same x-axis. We have same markings here. Xn here. Xp. Okay? As I told you, here no charge. So electric field is zero. As we travel along the x-axis, electric corresponding y value is zero till here. Then it will increase, but in negative direction because we are giving. Okay, so it will increase like this, right? And then from here to here. Okay. Electric field will be always from positive to negative. Okay, right? So here, okay, positive ions, negative ions. So it will be from here to here, opposite direction. Right? Negative. Clear? So this will be the plot for electric field. Can I erase this? Anybody write this on their hand? Okay, right. Now, tell me, which case the electric field will be more? More charges or less charges? More charges together, the electric field will be more. Okay? Right? So, electric field is directly proportional to the number of charges. Okay? Right? To get the charge, number of charges into charge of electron will give the charge. So more the charge, more will be the electric field. Okay? Right? Here we have seen electric field is a function of distance. Okay? So x. Right? E is proportional to this. If I put equal, we have to consider the proportionality constant, right? So the exact relation is this. The exact relation is electric field is given by qNa x by epsilon. Epsilon is permittivity of semiconductor. Okay? Remaining Q, Na, X, X is in the X axis, everything we know. Okay? This is actually magnitude. We will consider only magnitude. Okay? So, magnitude of electric field will be given by this. Right? Now let us take the what happens in a capacitor. Okay? Say, which case electric field will be more? When the voltage is more or less? See, electric field is nothing but, if you take a unit positive charge, if you place it here, what is the force that is experienced on that? Right? So, more the voltage, more will be the force experienced. experienced on the unit charge. Right? Now tell me, will it be directly proportional to voltage or inversely proportional to voltage? Directly proportional to voltage. Right? Next. Which case you feel more hot? Suppose we have another sun. Okay? Which case you feel more hot when you are close to the sun or far from the sun?
Close to the sun.
Close to the sun. Right? Now, same. So it is like this. Distance is less, heat is more. Directly proportional or inversely proportional? Right? Now tell me, electric field intensity with distance, directly proportional or inversely proportional? Okay? Right? So, combining these two, okay? For varying fields, here electric field is not a constant. Okay? For varying fields, E is given by dV by dx. Okay? The expression for electric field intensity is dV by dx. Okay? So, anybody like this? Raise your hand. Right. Next. What will be the expression for charge? Charge, as I told you, see, Na is number of charges per unit volume. Okay? Na is number of charges per unit volume. If you want the total number of charges, multiply with volume. Okay? Volume is area into width. Right? Hello? Stand up. Come and stand here and listen. Not interested? Want to pass? Come and stand here. Fast. So, huh? What? Anything? Okay, so area into width. This is charge per unit volume. Okay? Number of charges per unit volume. To get total number of charges, this. To get the total charge, multiply with what? This is only number of charges. Total number of charges. To get the total charge, see it is like this. You have 5 pens. Each pen costs 7 rupees. Total how much? 7 into 5. Each charge how much? Q. So multiply with Q. Right? Next. What is capacitance? What capacitance this is? Transistor capacitance. So CT. Previous case diffusion, so CD. Okay? Same. dQ by dV. Same. Okay? So from this, what will that be? Q, NA, right? A. When you increase reverse voltage, depletion width will increase. So depletion width W is a function of reverse voltage. So I have to write it like this. Rest all are constants. Okay? This will be the expression for CT. Now we need V. Okay? Now we need V. So what will E be? Integral from this. Okay? From this V is integral E dx. Right? stand out, use it here, get the CD, we'll continue in the next class. Try it, try it, the next class will become very easy. Good afternoon.